I will sing a duet for you. Come on up here, Mike. Where you at, Puck? Come on up here. Huh? He left? No, come on up here, Friar Puck. Hey, if you didn't know, Friar Puck is here today. So good to have him back. You haven't heard Friar Puck in a long time. Yeah, there you go. Plaid man. So listen, I know not everyone. Who doesn't know who Mike is? There's some of you that don't. Samuel. Mike was our college pastor for about 3 years here. And he was a NAM appointee and missionary. And funding kind of dried up and things went a different direction. And he had to find a job. So anyway, he found himself at Appalachian State, as the mountain man here. And he's been in college ministry there. And as things have been going, if you're not aware, through the cooperative program and through the special offerings, there's more money, but it doesn't go as far. And so missionaries are now having to come and ask for help. Now, Mike has not asked for this. I'm doing this. We will take up a love offering at the end of service if you want to give to his ministry. He actually has to raise funding for himself now. So he is going to ask that he can meet with you all during the week if you want to individually be involved in his ministry, whether that's prayer, participation, or financially, or whatever you feel God's laid on your heart. So because Mike has been a blessing to us, he's a part of our family, we want to give him the opportunity. But today he only asked to come share with you. I'm the one that's putting that. And actually, that was Nelson's idea, so blame him if you don't like it, okay? All right? So, but I want to pray. Yeah, there you go. I want to pray for Mike. And pray for his ministry, and then we're going to let him share a little bit with us what's going on. Heavenly Father, we just love you. Thank you for today. And we thank you for Mike and Kelly and Emily and the blessings that they have been to us and the blessings that they've been to college students now here and in North Carolina and even beyond that. I know that Mike's gone on an overseas mission, too, with collegiate stuff. So I just pray, God, you continue to bless his ministry, bless his family. And Father, bless Broadman Baptist Church, as they're a part of this journey with him. So, Father, today may we be blessed by the words he says, and may we be appreciative and be generous in what we can do to help him in his future ministry goals. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Pray, brother.
Well, I can tell you, can y'all hear me okay? Is this good? Okay. I can tell you guys that something that I did not expect to happen when I walked in this morning, it felt more like coming to my home church than going to my home church. And I'm not just saying that. Like, it really did. I love visiting the folks that I was raised by in my local church when I go visit family and whatnot. But, boy, it feels like coming home here. And I thought that would be, we had hoped that would be the case when we lived here, that we would say that and thought that maybe it might be a line for us to say. But, no, it really is. It's like coming home. It is good to be with you all today. I just want to give you a few minutes, a little update on what God is doing in the Puckett family, what our ministry is doing, just a little snapshot, but I could ramble incoherently for hours and hours, and we're not going to do that, which is why I'd like to just give you the tip of the iceberg here and then invite you to come talk to me at the back. I'll just have a little sign up for like my newsletter thing, and we can talk about finding some time to connect either personally or what I think could be really fun too is I'm planning on just being here in the evenings for the next few nights, Sunday, Monday, and I think Tuesday, to be able to host any group of folks that want to come and talk and catch up and hear a little bit about what our ministry is doing. So I'm currently the executive director of Baptist Campus Ministry of the High Country. What that means is in the old days of BCM or BSU, the Southern Baptist Collegiate Ministry effort that is traditionally focused in the South regions of the United States. We are in Boone, North Carolina. It's in the northwest corner of our state, and it is a little mountainy area. So your weather is our weather in a lot of ways. I walked into that thinking I would be the guy helping transition an old style of ministry to a new style of ministry. And what I didn't even realize when I walked into it was after about a year and a half, it would require me to lead our entire team, our entire ministry, away from being salaried and funded by the convention, and instead we would all have to raise our own funds. Now, I knew that was a possibility, not necessarily a likely whatnot, I figure you need to at least see who I'm representing. If you want to hit the next slide. So that's us, right? And a little chubby baby is about a year ago, not this past Christmas, but the Christmas before. And it's really just the best picture of the three of us that we've got. And if you've had one kid, you know how hard it is to start getting family pictures again. Doesn't happen. So that's us. Kelly is playing music at our home church down in Boone now, and Emily is just rocking and rolling. Can you hit the next one? That's her. I can't help but show these pictures. Some of y'all have seen that one on the right like four times today. I don't care. Let's talk afterwards. I'll show it to you again. She put my socks on, and then I just threw it on the bed. You know, she just thought that was the funniest thing. That is Emily. She turned two about almost a month ago. This is my team that I work with. So on the left is a girl named Bailey. She's serving at Lees McRae College. It's a little college of about 1,000 students that's just about 40 minutes from our main campus and is just small enough and just far enough away that everybody forgets about it. We started as a Christian school, and it has gone extremely liberal. And even though there are two churches literally in the middle of the campus, a Methodist and Presbyterian church, there is barely any gospel presence there whatsoever. I'm the one with the beard. The one in the middle, her name is Molly. She's done some admin and freshman work for us. Anna's the next one over. Anna quit her job 4 years ago to join BCM. And I met her when I was serving here. Went to a collegiate ministry summit. Met her while she was working with the guy that I had worked for, not knowing I would ever end up there again. In fact, telling them directly, yeah, I'm not leaving Ohio. It's not going to happen. I love what's going on, but it's not going to happen. Those words didn't taste too bad. Anna had to quit her job and start raising her funds to be able to do what she does, and has had two kids in the process. Her husband, Scott, who's not in the picture, has actually just been approved to join our staff as well. So he's quitting his job to raise his funds and join our missionary team. And then the fellow on the far right, his name's Chris, and he's a campus missionary with us at Appalachian. So this is our team. You can hit the next one. That is Appalachian State. That's where we serve. It is a beautiful place. It's a cold place, very windy. It is a place that is sort of a dark, dark place in the midst of a very Bible-saturated culture. Mountain culture is conservative. Mountain culture is not what you would call progressive. They're very kind, warm people there. But on the campus, it is a very different scene. And much like the campuses here at Kent State, the University of Akron, and others like it, you see tomorrow's culture. This is one of the places where we serve. Can you hit the next slide? That's Lees McRae College. It's the forgotten little brother or whatever. I don't know what you want to call it. It's small and beautiful and often overlooked. And it's even harder to reach than Appalachian is because it's so small and it's so tightly knit that when we go on campus, everyone knows we're not from there. You can't hide. This is just some of our students on a night hike that we took the very beginning of the school year. And I think we have one more. Yes. I'm going to describe just a little bit of our ministry to you. And this is where I'll just give you a tip, and then we'll talk later. So 3 years ago, I made the transition to go back to Boone. In the South, collegiate ministry is very much built on budgets, buildings, programs. Statewide North Carolina Baptist Convention. I knew when they were reassessing what collegiate ministry in North Carolina does, they looked at it and they realized they were spending about $1 million a year on 9 programs across the state. Well, Appalachian was one of the beneficiaries of that program. Lees McRae is a great example of the oversight involved in that. You can't scale that to the campuses the way that we need to. We have 160 campuses. We only had a presence on 9 of those campuses. And some of those were pretty weak. And the convention realized this is not a good stewardship. We are not using our funds well. And so that's why we are in positions where we're raising our own funds. Because as they've already started to defund those programs and spend their money on starting things rather than sustaining things, in the last year we've already seen about 35 new programs start. That's amazing. That's amazing. And it's all starting with local. local churches. Their team is working with local churches. So you hit the next slide. I do have one more. This is our team at Lee's McRae with one church. It's just a church that is excited about reaching this little unreached campus. And we took them out and prayer walked that campus for a couple hours that night. Instead of their Wednesday service, they bussed everybody by 20 minutes in. And they went and prayer walked around the campus. And we're starting to recognize we can't reach students the way we thought we could. The old way doesn't work anymore. We can't have a program and expect students to come to it. So we're reevaluating our entire process. Churches used to serve us by bringing meals to college students before we did a worship service, but neither of those two things were working well. We're starving our churches of relationships with students and with the campus, and we were just kind of assuming that we would actually get some traction by being able to do a program for students rather than training students to share the gospel and follow Jesus in their daily lives. The last picture that was up, we were sitting around the tables, was just one where Chris, one of my guys on my team, was leading a training with a handful of college guys, and that was in our little facility that we still have. We'll be moving away from that here soon. It is an example of our new way of doing ministry. I'm not the guy who's going to reach college students. College students are the ones who are going to reach college students. But it's my job to equip them to know how to follow Jesus obediently and share their faith effectively. And that's what BCM of the High Country is about. It used to be Appalachian State BCM, and we were focused very, very shortly on the one campus and the programs that we ran to bring those students in. When we opened our eyes, we realized as these campuses are being ignored across the state, there are some that are being ignored by us in our part of the state. And so there isn't just Appalachian in Boone. It feels that way. But in our corner of the state, you know, it doesn't matter what that part is, from North Carolina. That's where I normally tell people who are from North Carolina what our state boundaries are, but it doesn't matter. We have 14 campuses all around us. No one's engaging any of those except for Appalachian. No one. Appalachian's only got about 18,000 students. It's a good medium-sized school. But that entire region and all those little campuses, the commuter colleges and the community colleges and things like that, we've got over 80,000 students involved in those campuses. And the vast majority of them are people who are from that area, raised in that area, and will stay in that area. And if we want to see the mountains just blow up with God's glory, it's going to be through those people who are from there, are staying there, and will continue to stay there in the future. But no one's going after them. That's what our job is. So our focus is to reach these 14 campuses. As PC alluded, we are just getting ready to start a partnership in China. If I was writing it in print or on Facebook, I'd say East Asia, but since we're here in China, there's a city that we've just adopted. It's a university city that is on the east part of China, about 2 hour train ride from Shanghai. 7 million people in the city, and 1 million of them are college students. 55 campuses. About 7 students in that city came to know Christ over Christmas through the efforts of our Southern Baptist students who went for Christmas in China and spent 2 weeks. They gave up their Christmas holiday. They gave up their family time, and we saw just a handful of students give their lives to Christ. Wouldn't have happened without them. And so our